Guys, welcome to my channel. So rice versus chapati. So this is the most common and controversial topic. Both this grain being the staple food in many parts of the globe. So let's see which one is more safer and healthier. Also the myths behind them and the right way of consuming. So let's begin. So before going to calories, let's have a look on something which is known as glycemic index. So it is a parameter of how food affects blood sugar level. So more the glycemic index, more it will spike your insulin level. So moving on to the calories. So one medium sized whole grain roti has 100 calories. So that is, it contains 20 grams of complex carbs. So complex carbs burn slowly and provide energy for a long period of time. 3.5 grams of proteins, 2.5 grams of dietary fibers, and very negligible amount of fats. And the glycemic index comes to be 62. So on other hand, one cup cooked rice contains 245 calories, so 53 grams of simple carbs. Simple carbs burns fast and provide energy for a short period of time. 4.4 grams of proteins, 0.7 grams of dietary fibers, negligible amount of fats, and the glycemic index comes to be 73. As you can see, dietary fibers are very low in rice as compared to wheat. So the question arises, why rice is not a good source? This is because we mostly use polished or white rice, which looks white due to the removal of husk and bran, which are high in dietary fibers, and during this removal process, most of the micronutrients are also washed away. So according to this theory, even if you consume two rotis, you just get 200 calories, and if you consume one bowl of rice, you get 250 calories approximately. So roti is a good source, but for rice lovers, you have a good news. That is, brown rice. So modern science was all up for this whole grain because of its high fibers and full of micronutrients, but according to the recent reports, they contain some anti-nutrients which hinders the absorption of vitamins and minerals, so they are not recommended now. So you have something which is known as semi-brown rice or also hand-pounded rice. So they are high in micronutrients and also contain low glycemic index, so they are recommended. Are actually made through an ancient technique in which the brown rice is beaten, which removes the anti-nutrient which hinders the absorption of vitamins and minerals. So this might not be easily available in the market, so I'll share a link in the description below. You can order online. So moving on towards roti, include multigrain roti. So include oats, ragi, maize, jowar, chana dal, bajra along with wheat. So this will increase the dietary fibers and also reduce the glycemic index. So the right way of eating rice is, eat hand pounded rice, also known as semi brown rice. Do not remove the starchy water of the cooked rice. Use them in dal because they are high in micronutrient. Cook the rice in the same water as it was soaked in. Have rice in lunch and avoid them in dinner. So right way of eating roti is, avoid maida, eat multigrain roti, eat cucumber salad in lunch and ginger in dinner for faster digestion of roti. Roti can be included any time of the day but not more than twice a day. So other important considerations are, rotis are high in sodium and potassium content. Rice does not contain sodium and very little amount of potassium. Thus, people on sodium and potassium restricted diet, rice could be the better choice than chapatis. Rice are easy to digest as they are low in fibers. So people suffering from diarrhea, indigestion, rice is a good choice. As wheat are low in glycemic index than rice, roti is preferred option for diabetic patients. And for obese or overweight patient, roti is a better choice as they are high in fibrous type. If you hope you like this video, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe and share your views in the comment section below. Till then, bye and press the bell icon.